Hello students, I Professor Pooja Kalange from ISMR MCA welcome you all to this video lecture on Hungarian method of assignment for minimization. Already I have covered some topics of job sequencing and simplex method. I have just left out with one video. I'll be uploading it shortly. So today I'll be taking a video on assignment problem for Hungarian method. This is very easy problem. Just you know, need to know these steps. Whenever you'll follow these steps properly, you'll get the problem solving correctly. Now along with this, I'll be sharing the PDF with you. In this there is one more problem I've solved for minimization, which I've taken in the class, and after this I'll try to take one more lecture for the Hungarian method for maximization. It is also very simple, just there is a change of one step in the problem. I'll just let you know that. So we'll start for today. You can see here the problem given to you here is, I'll just zoom out. Sorry, I'm trying to use this PDF viewer because I had copied these images in the PowerPoint, but when they are getting uploaded, the video clarity is getting blurred. So today I thought I should try with this PDF, direct with the PDF rather than taking it into the PPT. So let's begin. So you can see here, this is a problem given to you, where it is a 4x4 matrix with the elements of the array 1, 4, 6, 3, 9, 7, 10, 9, 4, 5, 11, 7, and 8, 7, 8, 5. So first thing in Hungarian method of assignment, you need to check is step 1, whether m is equal to n, that is whether number of rows is equal to number of columns. So in this case, the number is correct. So the given matrix is a square matrix, okay. Now the second step in this is, you need to calculate the smallest element from every row and you need to subtract it from remaining elements of that row. Means, for example, if you see the first row, the minimum element is 1 out of 1, 4, 6, 3. So first row will be 1 minus 1, that is 0, 4 minus 1 will be 3, 6 minus 1 will be 5, and 3 minus 1 will be 2. Similarly, the minimum element in second row is 7. So 9 minus 7 is 2, 7 minus 7 is 0, 10 minus 7 is 3, and 9 minus 7 is 2. So similarly, you'll calculate for the remaining two rows, okay. So the step number 2 is select smallest element from each row and subtract it from remaining elements of each row. So the matrix will look in this way. Now the third step here is, you need to find out minimum element from each column, that is step number 3. And you have to subtract it from remaining. Now if you see column 1, no need to change because minimum element is 0. Column number 2, again minimum element is 0. But if you see column number 3, the minimum element is 3. So 5 minus 3 will result into 2. Then 3 minus 3 will be 0. And 7 minus, this is 7 minus 3 will be 4. And 3 minus 3 will be 0. So the image will look, or the matrix will look in this way in the step number 3. Now what you need to do is, you need to draw minimum number of lines to cover maximum number of zeros. Now in some books they have used a tick mark method, but the book which I have referred is using this technique only. So both the ways which is feasible for you, you can use the technique. In some books the tick mark is given first and the lines are drawn, but in my case I'm first trying to draw minimum number of lines based on which will cover maximum number of zeros. So if you see here, I have drawn three lines which are covering maximum number of zeros. The lines, number of lines should be never exceed the size of matrix, that it should not be 5, it should be either 4 or less than 4, okay. So in this case, now if you see, so in this case now the number of lines are not equal. So what you need to do is, you need to go to step number 5. In step number 5, what is you need to do is, you need to find smallest element from uncovered elements. Now see, where the lines are being drawn, that elements are said to be covered elements, and wherever the line is being not drawn, that elements are said to be uncovered. Means 3, 2, 2, 1, 4, 3 from row A and row C are uncovered. So the minimum element from 3, 2, 2, 1, 4, 3 is 1. So you need to subtract from this all 6 elements. So 3 minus 1 will be 2, 2 minus 2 will be 1, sorry, 2 minus 1 will be 1, 2 minus 1 will be 1, 1 minus 1 will be 0, 4 minus 1 will be 3, and 3 minus 1 will be 2. So if you see here, you have got 2, 1, 1 and 0, 3, 2 in the uncovered elements. Now along with this, you need to add this element 1 at the point of intersection. So the point of intersection is at element 2 in B row and 3, at d rho. So 2 plus 1 will be 3 and 3 plus 1 will be 4. So if you see this matrix here, this is the next matrix which you have got after covering the uncovered elements, finding out the minimum from the uncovered elements, subtracting it from the remaining uncovered elements and adding that element at the point of intersection. Okay, now comes the last step, is again you have to draw minimum number of lines which will cover maximum number of zeros. Now in this case you just have a trial and error error method at home when you're practicing. So in this case, if you see, the number of lines is 4, which is equal to size of matrix, so the allocation is being done. Now you need to do the final allocation. So when you will be doing assignment, you have to assign zeros in such a way which will have only one assignment in each row and each column. So if you see here, first if I allocate at first position of first row and first column, I will need to cross the zeros which are present in that particular row or column, so I cannot allocate to the zero back again. So if I have done allocation at the first position in first row or column, that is 0. Now in next row I have done the allocation at C position, in third row I have done the allocation at B position, and in the last row and column I have done the allocation at fourth position. So this step I cannot show you here because there is no any this present here, a pen or editor I can show you. So this you can just have a solving by yourself. So here what you need to remember is at the last step you need to assign zeros in such a way that there will be allocation one at a time, not two rows or two column will have same assignment in that particular row or column. And finally when this allocation is done, you should get four values corresponding to four different rows and columns. After this, you need to do is you need to find the original value where you have done the allocation, like at this first position the value is 1, at the third position the value is 5, at the fourth position value is 10, and at last position the value is 5 in the original matrix. You need to take that values and you need to just add that values, okay, original value. So this is 1 plus 10 plus 5 plus 5, so total 21 units is the minimized cost for allocation. So this was about the assignment problem. I'll just share this problem to you in notes, means if in case the video looks to be blur, you can refer this PDF for solving. Along with this problem, there is one more problem which is solved at the front side, you can refer that problem also. So I hope you must have understood this assignment problem for minimization. If still there are any queries, please let me know, and thank you for watching.